Yo, what's good? This is St. Joe, SoundsOfGear.com. Today, checking out The Attic by Sonic Couture. This is definitely a product I wanted to show you. If you're into quirky analog synths and organs and electric pianos and different stuff like that, it's definitely something you want to check out. Now, this is a Kontakt player library, so it works with the free version of Kontakt. It has like 10 different instruments in there. Then there's also like 350 presets. So I want to go through and show you the different instruments that are included and then get into some of the sounds and presets so you can see what's going on. So let's check it out. All right, so here's the Attic interface. You can see you got presets for each individual instrument and then actual sound type presets, keys, leads, pads, different stuff like that. So I'm gonna go through each individual instrument and then go through some of the sounds in here. Right now I got the Mini Korg 700 pulled up, and again, the Sonic Couture interfaces, you know I'm a big fan of those if you've seen any of my videos on their stuff before. Really nice, clean interface. This one's laid out really well. You got your waveform section right here. And anytime you see these little squares, if you click on them, it's like a hidden menu, so you can go through there. You got your high pass, low pass filter section right there. You can go there to the resonance. Then over here, of course, you got your envelope settings. You can go over there and adjust your sustain and release. Down here, you got your vibrato, your different switches, and your portamento and detune. Then on each of the instruments, you have this same effects page, which is really clean, really nice, really well laid out, and it's the same across all of them, so you know what you're doing. You can go through, click on the different ones, or if you want to activate them, just click the button. So what I want to do is check this one out, and then we'll get into some of the other ones. Turn on the poly. Different waveforms, and of course you can go over here. You can see right there, you can just pull them up. And of course you can go in and MIDI assign these knobs if you want. So let's check out the next one. So here's the Univox. You got all your different switches up here, different vibrato settings. Then you got your different stops, your sub octave, poly mode, your level, your follower. That's basically gonna route your LFO to your frequency cutoff. Then you can see your different parameters for your vibrato depth and stuff like that. So cool stuff. And then this is your envelope settings, faster to slower envelopes. If you hear it without that sub, so that sub octave really adds some nice punch to it. Again, you still got your effects over here. You can go in and turn on some chorus. Turn on phaser. So again, cool stuff. Let's go to the Omnichord. Now the Omnichord is cool because you got all your different chords right here. You can go in and pick them with your mouse. You got the strum section over here. This is automatically assigned to your mod wheel. You got chord mode on, so that means the keyboard is going to switch through the chords. If you turn it off, you can play your own chords, but you can still strum them. So really cool. This one is definitely a quirky instrument. or you can just go through and pick the ones you want. And then you got your detune. So of course, if you want to sequence these changes into your DAW, that's what the keyboard mode is for. So if you got that chord mode on, you can go through and record those key changes. But if you just want to do it manually, it's going to play and strum whatever chords you have, and you still got your effects over there as well. So let's go to the fill quarta. Again, really clean interface, go through buttons. Again, a really clean interface, which is one thing I love about all their interfaces, nice and clean, easy to go through and manipulate. You got your buttons up here. This actually has a chord mode. The chord keys are down there. You can adjust the level for that. You got your vibrato, your envelope. Then, of course, you got your filter over here, and you still got your effects that you can go in and tweak. So listen what this sounds like. You got your chords down here. You can go through and change the sound. Let's say if I click all these up, then there'll be no sound up here, and you'll have your chords down here. Just depends on what you want it to sound like. You got your filter. So again, straightforward stuff. Again, I'm just going through each one and then we'll go through some of the presets. There's your RS-202 string machine. Again, you got your switches at top and you got some sliders down here. Right now it's got the ensemble turn on. So if you like those analog string sounds, really cool. Again, you see those squares, so you can go in and you got your speed and different settings for the filter. Same over here with the envelope. You can go in there, you got your attack and velocity. You can turn the ensemble off if you want. I like it on. Settings there, you can turn to this one. And again, you still got your effects. So let's say we want to turn on the cabinet. So again, just some really cool quirky instruments. Let's check out the Korg electric piano. Another clean interface, straightforward. It's really easy to understand what's going on. You got your tone select over here, decay, sustain, your detuning, and then your EQ. And then over there, you got your effects page. Again, you can turn off whichever ones you want. The piano. Detune a little bit. On with the piano. So really cool there. And then of course you got your EQ settings there. Alright, so straightforward, you got your different oscillator types over there. I guess you can call them oscillators, different, you know, bass, tenor, alto, soprano. Mute kind of adds some harmonics. You got your vibrato, attack, and then over here it's kind of like your formant filter section of deep in the first, second. You got your filter down here, mono, poly, and your envelope right there. Then of course your volume and the effects page. So again, straightforward interface, easy to mess with. So again, cool stuff. Let's see, we got the Goodwin String Concert. All right, so you can see right there, you got your levels for your different tones. You got your tone settings, bass, treble, basically your EQ, your modulation. You can go in there and adjust the drift and the width. And then, of course, you got your controls for the envelope over there. So you want to turn this down, and maybe you want to turn this up. And of course, you can assign this stuff. If you got faders on your controller, you can do that. Turn up some tremolo. Got your little EQ over here. So again, quirky instruments, but really fun, and their sampling is just on point, really sounds good. The SH-2000, another clean interface. You'll see right here, you can actually assign what you want these to be controlled by. This one's by the mod wheel, the filter, and the growl is set to attack. Then you got your glide, your wow setting, LFO, filter, envelope controls, and these are actually the presets down here that they went through and sampled those. You actually have two banks, so we'll just go through some of those so you can hear what they sound like. And then you got three different ones for the synthy. You got the hits and ambience, you got the loops, and then you got the multi-samples. And as you can see, you got your filter up here, you got your LFO, you got your envelope over there, and you can see I have it select by MIDI, so each time you hit a key, it shows you which one you're hitting. Let's check out the loops. This now the interface is going to look a little different because you got the loops in this one. So you can see this one can get really fun. Individual slice, and of course you still got all your effects and stuff over there, and then you got the synthy multi-sample. Now, this one's definitely my favorite instrument just because I just like the way it sounds, and of course the layout is really cool as well. You see, you got those two different layers. You can mix and match them. So you get the idea. Now I know it's getting kind of long, but I wanted to make sure you saw each individual instrument. Now we'll go through some different, maybe a couple of presets from each folder, but you can see there's a lot of content you get. In addition to the individual instruments, you got all these different presets to go through as well. Just lots of stuff, and you can see there's tons and tons of sounds in there. Let's do one more from here. We'll go to the next one. So yeah, man, really great sound. They did a terrific job programming this stuff. I'm just trying to go through and give you an idea of the type of presets that come. Everybody's going to have their favorite instrument in this pack, but it's really cool that they all come together and you can try out different ones. I mean, that bass is crazy. Yeah, Yeah, man, so you can see, we can keep going all day. I know this is kind of long, but there's a lot of stuff in this package. I wanted to make sure you understood what was in there. So in addition to all the individual instruments, you get a bunch of different presets. So if you don't want to go in and create your own, you can see all these different presets that are in there. I didn't even get to go through half of the presets, but you get the idea, man. Really, really cool stuff in there. And again, Sonic Couture's interfaces, man, I'm definitely a fan. I like how clean and simple they are. Very functional. Nothing gets in the way. You can see where everything's at. It's just a nice and clean interface. So let me know what you think, man. I give this a 4 out of 5 subs, man. I think it's a really, really great product. I like that they put all these different quirky instruments in there together. My favorite out of there is probably the Synthi. My second favorite would probably be the SH-2000. But again, I like playing with all the different ones. Even that Omnicord is really cool. You do some stuff that you normally wouldn't do. So you can get this directly from their website. As you can see, it's $149. And right now they're having a 33% off sale. If you go to their homepage, you can get the code, and that's on anything on their website. So if you're looking at getting it, make sure you go over there and get that code and take advantage of that sale. This is a Kontakt player library, so it works in the free version of Kontakt or the full version. So let me know what you think. Rate, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Again, this is St. Joe, soundsandgear.com, checking out the Attic from Sonic Couture. 4 out of 5 subs, man. Really, really cool stuff. You can see right there, 10 different instruments, 350 presets. It's really a cool library if you like that quirky analog sound. So let me know what you think. I'll see y'all later. Peace. Thank you.